Let's say I'm building a new vehicle fleet management application, and I'm ready to set up the data. My first step is to create my record types and structure my data. In this video, I'll walk through how I model my data, first by connecting to an existing database table, and then by generating a new one. Let's get started. Each record type represents an important business entity. For Acme Auto's fleet management app, I will start by creating two main record types, vehicle and maintenance. But there will ultimately be record types representing each database table. I'll start with vehicle. In Appian Designer, click New, Record Type. First, I'll give it a name and a description. Notice that a display name will automatically be generated. This name will be visible to business users. Make sure your names and descriptions are clear and specific so someone else can easily understand what data is in the record type. Next, configure the record type object's security to determine who can view and modify the record type. Any user with viewer permission can see the records in the record type, but only users with editor or administrator privileges can modify the record type. As a best practice, use groups to determine who has access to the record type. I can keep the default configuration, but note that there are multiple layers of record type security that will be configured later. Once in the record type, I'll create my data model to get started. Because I already have data for the vehicles in a database table, I'll select Database. Keep in mind that a connection to the source must already exist. Next, I'll keep Data Sync enabled so I can use all the powerful record type features. Now, I'll choose the source database table, AA Vehicle. When you select a table, you can see a preview of the data. The next step is to configure source filters. Use source filters to decide which source data is synced and available in Appian. Your data design will impact whether you use source filters. For example, if you know you'll have millions of rows of data, you can use source filters to exclude or split up data. So you could exclude data that is outside a certain time frame or split up data by region into different record types. You can change or remove filters at any time and the updates will sync. For this record type, I'll filter out vehicles that are older than the year 2000. Now, I can take a closer look at the fields in my table and decide whether I want to rearrange, remove, or rename any fields. Because you'll use these fields throughout your app, make sure the fields are clearly named so developers can understand them. Only select fields that are relevant for your app and order them in a logical way. Also, keep in mind that a primary key is required. The primary key is used as an identifier for each row in the database table. Next, I'll change the data type of a few fields because in Appian, user-related fields are the user data type. When I click Finish, the data model page is populated with my selected fields. Here, you can find details about the source, relationships, and more. Before I'm done, I'll click Save Changes. Next, I'll create the maintenance record type. I'll start with similar steps: creating a new object, giving it a meaningful name and description, and configuring the object security. However, I don't have any existing maintenance data, so when I configure the data source, I'll click New Data Model, then select the data source. Next, I can add the fields I need in my data model. When you're generating a new data source, you'll have to identify the fields to include in your data model. You should identify these fields during planning stages. If you think about the business processes where you will use this data, you'll have a good sense of which fields to include. To add other fields, you can click New Field or simply select from the list of commonly used fields. It's also easy to create choice lists for lookup data that you can use to reference a set of values like states, priority level, or status. You can choose from the options on the right or create your own by clicking New Choice List. For my maintenance data, I need to capture information about the request, like the issue, mechanic, and other data that will be captured in the process, such as modified on and by. Name the fields using camel casing and choose the appropriate data type. I also want to capture the status of the request and the review. When I click Status, a dialog opens where I can enter the different statuses. This creates a new record type that will be used to look up the status values. Because there are also reviews of maintenance requests, I'll click New Choice List to add another choice list for the review status. Great, now that I've added my fields, I'll look at the relationships. Relationships allow you to connect related data and reference it throughout your app. Notice that any field that is a user data type is automatically related to the user record type, allowing you to access your environment's user data, such as name or email. Before moving on, I'll add a many-to-one relationship from maintenance to vehicle, so I can easily access related vehicle information from the maintenance record type. Multiple maintenance requests can be related to a single vehicle. Finally, I can review and modify my data model before saving changes. Now, tables will be created for maintenance and the statuses. When I click Finish, I can download the database script, which can be used to deploy changes to the database table when moving the app to different environments. Just like before, I can now see my data model on this page. I can also modify both my source fields and the record type fields if I need to.